Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and oh boys, oh boys. As all of you know, from time to time I'm checking the new streamers, what is happening in the Twitch world and so on. And today we have a pleasure watching Dark Ninja replay. I checked this guy out and this is the battle which he had. And I said, come to Papi, give me this replay and I will make commentary on this one. This battle made my nipples go hard. So let's see. I know some of you don't like EBR Ferrari, but this battle was a masterpiece, okay? So let's watch it with a pleasure. Also, shout out to Dark Ninja. His Twitch info is down in the description, so feel free to show some love for him. Every single of you know it's very hard to get bigger on Twitch and so on. So feel free to drop him a follow. Feel free to say hi on, or feel free to skill bomb him if we can say so. Send him some big wet bananas. Anyways, what he is doing right here, he's playing on Westfield, he is having EBR, and he is starting everything from countering the Bushwankers, which is playing over there, which is very interesting thing. I did not saw this kind of play yet. Speaking about loadout, majority of the hits, it's completely understandable because nowadays when there is so many super heavies in the battlefield, you need to have quite some hits. I prefer high explosives though, but you know, everyone has his each playstyle and everything. So what he is doing right here, he is just crafting for some shots. By the way, he's going to take the same bush over there to try to spot that scorpion. Scorpion is getting spotted, he is crafting another angle, and hip hip hooray, he managed to punish the scorpion for his mistake. Plus he is getting solid 6 assisting damage from that guy's side. Good. 6 is better than nothing. 1000 damage dealt so far, and the battle is looking very interesting. His team do not have the heavy line over there. Right there, no one is here, right? They are losing this side just because enemies have control over this, and this is looking like interesting situation already, right? They lost the Death Star. RIP. Hashtag never lucky. He is going to try to take a blind shot for someone who is playing over there. More likely he was trying to hit Progetto, more likely he did not hit that one. Anyways, situation 1-4, his team is losing this battle for sure, and look how this guy is playing. He's trying to craft a free shots in the left, in the right, and oh boys. When I was looking this replay, I thought, damn boy, you know how to play the game. What is happening right here? He's trying to eat that Vaz alive. Vaz got killed. By the way, this Jack Pizda is going to be a hero of the day. I believe you are going to have, let's say like that, fun time. And it's going to be clear why I do not play with tanks like Jack Pizda nowadays and why I absolutely hate them. Score 2-6. He's trying to play in the heavy line. Unfortunately, enemies is clearing the 7-8-9-0 line there. They have quite nice crossfire. Whenever this one fort is going to get spotted, it's going to be no bueno. This Dark Ninja managed to get the shot into the T-34, and look how he is relocating and how he is doing his things. He's like annoying mosquito. Well, in fact, very fast annoying mosquito. He managed to find a shot on the Type 61. Hip hip hooray, that was a good shot by this guy's side. Probably Dark Ninja is thinking where they're flying, if this 53 TP came from. It's understandable, I did not notice it, this guy either way. Now, more likely he tried to kill the T-34, but Arta gave him a hand right there, and look at the situation. Object 257, by the way, manually aim with the BR is very hard, just saying. And he managed to punish the 257 once right there. Now look, if Jack Pizda is hitting this guy, he is pretty much dead meat and not much what he can do about that. So more likely he was thinking about going into the open field, but he changed his mind because, you know, one mistake and you are going back to the garage, which is completely understandable. Now look at this beauty. He's going for the 257 right there. there. He managed to hit him once. Jack P is still paying attention at this annoying mosquito, and this guy probably is thinking, eh, F them, let's try to go and punish some other guys for their mistake. Look at this, he managed to set auto aim, and this shot was quite lucky and everything, but hey, it doesn't matter what is the execution, most important thing, it is working, right? Fellas, this was not the most exciting part, okay? Most exciting part of this replay is going to be very, very soon. So stay tuned. It's going to be awesome. And fellas, this is, if I'm not mistaken, my very, very first time when I'm commenting someone's replay. What this guy is doing, he's going on the full bananas right here. He's going super aggressively. He managed to find the shot into the 257. And when I said Jack Pizda is the hero of the day, I adore this guy patience. So what Dark Ninja is doing right here, he have some ninja moves. He's moving like this in the left, in the right, to avoid the two sky shits which is going to fap on him. And he's just farming this Jack Pizda right here. You know, what is the reason why I adore this Jack Pizda? Because he knows he's pretty much doomed. There is nothing what you can do for EBR, and he is still trying. He is still working right here. And now, this is the most important situation right here, fellas. 1v7. Let's see how this guy is going to end this battle. Jack Pizda is down to 600 hit points right here, and obviously Dark Ninja is just saying, and he is claiming that Jack Pizda life. Now pay attention, he is not finishing Jack Pizda, he is going for the light, and he is eliminating light from the game. E50 is getting spotted from the right side, and he is trying to make a decision, what does he want to kill? Does he want to kill Jack Pizda or E50M? He decided to kill Jack Pizda right here, and E50M is having quite hard time to flank the EBR. E50M just shot so EBR can punish him for his stupidity right here, and look at this masterpiece. He managed to win 1v3 like nothing. E50M shot once again, and E50M is getting pregnant in the ass. Now this is the most interesting thing for me, this kind of decision what he's doing. So his base is under the cap pressure right here, but what he is doing, he's going over there. I believe he was thinking maybe Artas will relocate, or alternatively he will find the TVP Vato. And it is the case. TVP Vato is going through the middle of the field while saying blah 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 blah. And he's getting slaughtered because EBR, the Dark Ninja, managed to find him, and he punished him for his mistake. This is the thing which I did not really understood, why to take the double bush, but it's okay. I believe it is important not to get spotted right there. 20 seconds on the timer, EBR versus EBR and two sky shit. So far, Clickers did not manage to punish this guy at all, but we'll see how long it's going to go like this. He managed to get the capturing shot, which is very important, and now he's running for his life. Turbo mode activated. Brrr. Nope. Brrr. Nope. He's down to 36 hit points right there. And now he have two choices what he wants to do. Either he is going to kill that EBR, which is capping the base, or he is going for the Artas. And you know what? This guy is going to kill EBR. One thing which I would do if I would be in his place, though, I would shoot more high explosives right here, but obviously APCRs and hits is more reliable than high explosives, and high explosives is going to work well to slaughter Artas if he is going to have a choice. Look how this guy is moving and what this guy is doing. I mean, I'm not even speaking about the score. I never ever had this kind of amount of the damage with EBR, if I'm not mistaken. I'm not sure, but I am pretty sure I never ever had this kind of amount of damage with EBR up so far. Maybe one day when I will grow up. Maybe, I'm not sure. Look what he is doing right here, trying to craft the angle for the EBR. He spotted the EBR, he's moving out of the bushes from where he spotted him. Now look, he's moving back to spot him once again. He's spotting him, he's moving out, and he is trying to get the right angle simply to eliminate him from the game. Masterpiece, fellas. Masterpiece. And there is a lot of... I can tell you that to get bigger in Twitch when you are new in the Twitch world and everything is extremely hard. I'm talking from my experience and so on. So once again, fellas, this is a shout out for Dark Ninja. Good job, well played. That was one of the most impressive battles which I catched, and congratulations. You carried and your back should hurt after this performance. Fellas, just solid banana out of 10. Obviously, it's not over yet. There is two artists left, but now look. EBR have the best camo, or one of the best camo in the tier, of the tier 10 lights, right? I think EBR have the best camo. He have more likely bond equipment, if I'm not mistaken, so his view range is very, very good. Artas, they are blind chickens, okay? They cannot see anything unless someone is spotting for them and saying, look, there is a grain on the ground, do you want to take it? So, it's pretty much victory from this moment right here. One or another way, fellas, this is one of the greatest games in the in EBR in World of Tanks, I would say. Once again, you know me, I'm not checking the replays in the World of Tanks replays or something. I don't really care about that. But if I am seeing the fellow streamer which is having the game, which is making my skin to have the goosebumps and so on, I believe at the least what I can do, I can shout him up and maybe I can help him a bit. And this battle, fellas, this battle was the battle which made my nipples to go hard. I was worried what he's going to do when he was fighting against Jack Pizda, E50M, in the same time the 3090. I was worried for him. This is emotions which I had while watching this live, and I hope you enjoyed this replay too. So once again, shout out to the Dark Ninja. Good job, man. Well played. I hope you are going to have a great success in the Twitch. I saw you are a new streamer, and for F's sake, have something below the stream. Information about yourself, and so on. That would be great. Anyways, fellas, thank you so much for watching. Feel free to show some love for Dark Ninja and see you next time. That was the very first time when I commented on the other people replays, not only myself, but once again, I saw that live, my nipples went hard. If my nipples is going hard, I must comment this one. Thank you so much for watching. It was a pleasure for me to make a review of this replay, and I hope you enjoyed this one as much as I did. See you next time. Skill is out. Peace.